Assalamualaikum and good afternoon. Okay, kita sambung balik yang last 2 weeks before you start your semester break. Still in chapter 3, reinforced concrete slab design. In the past, we already learn example number 1 and also exercise 3 ya, kita buat sama-sama. So today kita sambung example number 2 because akan ada dua jenis lah yang akan ditanya dalam exam. One is macam example one, dia minta you design. And as it for example two for today, the question asks you to find loading. Okay, daripada apa yang you design, you cari suitable, you cari limit post permissible loading yang dia boleh support lah. Maksudnya you punya slab boleh support. Okay, so only these two types of question yang akan keluar dalam final ataupun dalam test macam tu, eh. Okay. A reinforced concrete. So, example number 2. Reinforced concrete with 10mm diameter with high yield steel bar. Okay. If you see here, it says that FY is 460 and it's also stated the diameter you're going to use is 10mm. At 125mm center. So, if you look at this question, dia dah bagi dah apa kita panggil design dia, maksudnya the bar, maksudnya size apa, spacingnya berapa, given already. And if you look at here, the S also given, which means you don't need to refer to table. If let's say S is not given, okay, so you have to refer to table based on the spacing yang dia bagi kat sini. And then apa yang kita panggil diameter of bar ni untuk dapatkan berapa AS dia. Okay. Between brick walls as shown in figure. So, these two adalah brick wall eh. Calculate the maximum uniformly distributed imposed load the floor can carry. Given also FCU adalah 30. So, question ni minta maximum uniformly distributed imposed load. Meaning, imposed load UDL. Tu yang dia minta ya. Okay, first thing, when we have this kind of question, you need to find effective depth. Okay, bukannya dmin, bukan dminimum. We are not going to design, we just going to find the UDL for imposed load. Okay, first, we need to find the value of D. Okay, since given in the question, H ni 150. Mana dapat 150 ni yang ini? Bukan. Bukan yang ini ya. Bukan yang ini ya. Ini brick wall punya thickness. Okay, it is here 150 ini. Okay, jadi ini sebenarnya adalah you punya what we call it, yang saya selalu lukis tu kan, dia punya cross section of slab. Okay, jadi just tunjuk mana D, mana ni, mana ni. So given the H total height dia adalah 150. Okay, first kita cari D. Okay, by given the H 150, we minus with diameter divide by 2. Okay, given the question also 10mm ni given. Okay, kena check soalan ya. And then you have to minus 25mm the concrete cover. So this formula kita dah belajar dalam sebelum ni because dia berasal daripada H equal to D plus half bar plus C. Okay, then kita akan dapat value of D. Why we need to find D? Because we need to find the effective span. Okay, apa effective span ni? Effective span ni adalah jarak di antara center of, okay, jarak ni lah, senang cerita, jarak ini plus dengan effective depth. Okay, so itu adalah effective span. Okay, jadi kita tengok is center to center between bearings. Maksudnya between bearings tu, which means that between centroid ini sampai sini, center of brick wall sampai center of brick wall ni adalah 3000. Tu maksud dia. Okay. And then clear distance between support plus effective depth. Maksudnya sekarang ni between bearing tu 3000 ni. Okay. But then what you need to find is you nak cari clear span dia. So to find the clear span, we need this value. Berapa value ini sampai sini. Okay, jadi tolak dengan brick wall punya thickness. Okay, but here, kalau between bearing ni, kalau you tengok, dia sampai center of brick wall. Meaning, brick wall you 150, so you have the balance of 150 here. 75, sorry. You have the balance of 75 mm here. And here also you have 75 mm. Okay, sebab ini sampai tengah, you nak buang yang separuh ni. Okay, jadi 75 75, you tolak, you campur dua ni, you dapat 150. So 3000 tolak 150, you akan dapat 2850, which is sama dekat sini lah. Okay, 2850. And as I said, you kena plus dengan effective depth. Okay, plus with effective depth, and you dah kira up here 120 plus with 120, so the value is 2970 mm. That's the value of effective span. Alright. Okay. Another thing, sebab tadi as I mentioned, AS given. Okay, because kita akan kena kira AS dalam moment capacity here. Okay. So, after kita dah dapatkan that effective span. Okay. Jadi, kita kena kira moment capacity. Okay. Nak kira moment capacity ni kenapa? Sebab kita nak tahu dari segi moment kita tu akan terhasil daripada loading. Sebab sekarang kita nak cari loading. So, kita kena dapatkan value of moment. Okay. Sebab kita calculate backwards. Before this, kita calculate forward because kita nak design. But this time, we are calculating according to this question backwards. Assume, we have to assume first because we don't know the value of Z. Okay, kita tak tahu Z berapa because we have this formula. We have to use this as equal to M. Because kita nak kira moment kan? Equal to M divided by 0.95 FY Z. Okay. Sekarang kita nak cari M. Okay, sebab kita tak tahu the value of M. To get why we need to find M, because we need to find the loading. Okay, jadi M. Tak tahu berapa, leave it like that. And then 0.95 FY given dalam soalan 460. Z kita tak tahu berapa. Okay, but we know that Z must be some value D. Betul. D kita dah ada. But here, we don't know. 0.92 ke, 93 ke, 961 ke, kita tak tahu eh. So, kita akan assume to the maximum. Okay, masih ingat if let's say, before this, I said that if let's say we get the value of Z equal to 0.95, we going to use 0.95. So, value Z ni takkan lebih daripada 0.95. Okay, dia maksimum dia 0.95 untuk kira AS. Okay, macam yang you belajar sebelum ni. Jadinya, we going to use 0.95. Kita akan assume dulu Z ni value yang paling maksimum. Okay, put it 0.95 here. Okay, then we calculate. We going to get some value for M. Okay, kita akan dapat value for moment here, which is 31.286 times 10 power of 6 Newton mm. Maksudnya inilah. Dalam kilo newton meter. Okay. After kita dapatkan this moment capacity, kita boleh tengok on the loading. Okay. Because right now, kita nakkan that UDL imposed load. Means that we need to find QK. Okay. Imposed load QK. Okay. Jadi kita cari loading dulu. That load, we know that it is the self weight of the slab. So we have this is the thickness ataupun H, and then you need weight of concrete yang you belajar macam example sebelum ni sama saja, and then equal to 3.6. then we already have the dead load. Since tak ada dead load lain, mungkin daripada floor finishes and such, so we going to use this 3.6 as the final value for dead load. Then put it here, masukkan saja dalam the formula of ultimate load which we have here, 1.4 GK plus 1.6 QK ni ya. And then put it in the GK value. Right now we don't have this QK value, but never mind. Okay, sama juga kita masih lagi darab dengan this 1 meter, because we going, bila kita design, kita akan sentiasa design with the breath dia, maksud saya, for 1000 mm ataupun 1 meter. You will get some values, 5.04 kilonewton. Okay, biarkan saja dalam sebutan like this, like ada QK saja, because we don't know that QK. And we going to use we going to use some equation later on to find this QK. Okay, alright. So you akan dapat macam ni lah. After we get the equation for loading yang sebelum ni kita kira, jadi we can finally kira berapa, macam kita nak dapatkan value of QK dalam the formula MWL square actually here. Maafkan di situ ada typo. From this formula, okay, jadi kita masukkan je. Since kita dah ada value of M, so sekarang kita nak cari yang W ni, kita nak cari QK kan. Jadi we have W punya equation yang kita unsolve lagi the value of QK, and we have the value of moment yang kita assume M, Z adalah 0.95. Okay, and then length ni, we can use the effective span ya, for this to find the uniformly distributed load for imposed load. Kita tak pakai span biasa, which is kalau kita pakai span yang kita pakai sebelum ni, masa kita design, we use 3 meter. Okay, macam kalau ikut question ni lah. Okay, dalam soalan ni, dia bagi span adalah 3 meter. Okay, but actually we not going to use span 3 meter tu. Okay, kita akan pakai effective span instead. Ini 2970 ni. Kita pakai value yang ini. So, kita masukkan saja 2.97 as dia punya length. Okay, M, ambil saja yang value depan. Equation yang ni dapat daripada W punya equation, kita kira ultimate load. And then 2.97, the effective span, and divide by 8. So, how I solve this thing. Ini ada darab saja dengan ni. Okay, so I dapat to 50.288. And then 5.04, I darab dengan this one. Okay, 2.97 power of 2 darab 5.04, you will get this value. And 1.6 QK, you kena darab juga dengan this one, because both of this ni tambah, dia darab dengan this one. Jadi dua-dua ni you kena darab eh. Darab sama-sama 2.97. Then you akan dapat value macam ni lah. Okay, after that, kita nak dapatkan QK. How we solve this? So 250.288 minus 44.457, and we get some values, and divide with 14.113. Jadi, I dapat 14.584. But this value, this QK, kita memang dah dapat. Okay, kita dah dapat dah the imposed load. But we are not sure whether it is correct or not. Since, kita assume saja yang Z adalah 0.95D. Kita tak tahu betul ke Z 0.95D. So, to make sure we actually use the correct value for Z, kita akan kena kira lagi additional kat sini. Okay, using the formula of K. So K, masukkan saja based on the value of M yang you dapat earlier. Okay, this one sama eh, 31.286 eh, masuk kan. Divide by FCU given the question. And B, kita tahu slab mesti 1000 mm ataupun 1 meter. Okay, but here kita pakai mm. And D, we calculated sebelum ni masa kita kira effective span 120. Okay, and I dapat 0.072 here. After that, kita akan kira Z. Kenapa kita kira K? Sebab kita nak sebenarnya nak check Z ni. Betul ke 0.95? Okay. Unfortunately, bila kita kira kat sini, it is proven that Z adalah not 0.95 T. Okay. When Z is not 0.95 T, maksudnya dia tak sampai pun maksimum 0.95 tu. Okay. Kita kena kira balik. Kita kira balik the actual moment using 0.92 D. Okay. 912 D. Okay. Sebab sebelum ni, masa kita kira, kita assume ni. Okay. Masa kita kira AS kan. So, kita kena do the same but replace Z ni dengan 0.912 D. Alright. Mana punya? Okay. Assume again 0.912 D using what we get from when we check the value of Z. Okay, masukkan saja AS, same apa steps that we're going to use. We need to find the value of M but replace the Z with 0.912. Alright, now we get some values 30.034. The same step again, kita kena cari value of QK using M equal to WL square. Aduh, pasal dengan saya ni. Okay, WL square over 8. Okay, sama juga darablah satu-satu ni ke dalam ini. Then you get this value. And 8 ni you boleh darab dekat sini lah. You akan dapat 240.272. Okay, tapi ingat eh. M dekat sini. Kita pakai M yang kita dah pakai 0.1912D. Jangan pakai yang the old M. M yang tu masa kita assume Z adalah 0.95. Sekarang kita dah assume Z adalah 0.912. Jadi kita pakai value of Z adalah 0.912 untuk M eh. Masukkan saja dan you akan dapat QK 13.875. Okay, you can also check again whether it is correct but normally it is correct already sebab kita dah kira balik value of Z eh. Ikut yang the first one kita dah dapat the actual value of Z. Okay, but we can actually check. So actually here I dapat I check again using the K and the Z and I dapat 0.914 D but it's actually 0.12 D. Tapi tak jauh beza dia and this is probably because of beza dia pun 0.002 saja because of kat sini kita ada round up. Okay, kita ada round up values. Bila kita ada round up ni value last kali Z ni akan berubah eh. Kat sini pun sebenarnya 0.0695 something something if I'm not mistaken. Jadi kita ada round up then it costs the value of Z. Tapi beza dia tak besar. So betul lah sebenarnya eh. Sebenarnya memang betul. Jadi kalau you tengok kat sini, hence betul lah kita dah dapat value of Z maximum adalah 13.875. Okay. Kalau you compare this 13.875 dengan value yang masa you kira 14. Masa you assume Z 0.95 adalah 14.584. Okay. Tapi actual Z adalah 13.875. Okay. Jadi sebenarnya bila Z makin kurang, Z semakin turun eh, bukan 0.95. The actual value floor tu boleh carry adalah rendah lagi daripada 0.95 tu. Maksudnya lebih rendah Z, QK pun akan turun. Okay. Maksudnya, kalau katakan you tak recheck, you provide 14 point berapa-berapa, you pakai Z0.95. So, apa jadi dengan slab you? Slab you sebenarnya tak boleh support load sebanyak this one. You nampak memanglah beza dia sikit 1 kN per meter. Tahu itu per meter. Okay, kalau you tengok kawasan, kita bukan kira untuk 1 meter saja. We calculate for the whole thing kan. So, meaning loading dia sebenarnya lebih banyak eh. Okay, kalau lebihan 1 kN per meter pun can cause failure. So, kita kena provide betul-betul lah. That's why we need to check. Okay. How about if let's say kat sini, contohnya eh. You ingat eh, bila I cakap D tu, exact ni, maksimum dia adalah 0.95D. That's why masa kita mula-mula, kita assume 0.95D. Kita akan pakai tu the maximum. But value dia sebenarnya lebih rendah dan we use that the value of Z yang lebih rendah untuk calculate the actual QK. But kalau katakan bila you check, contohnya you check kat sini, you dapat Z adalah 0.961, which is bigger than 0.95D, lebih besar. So stop lah, maksudnya dah betul. Okay, maksudnya QKU okay. Okay, sebab kalau Z 0.961 you dapat, you kira kat sini you dapat 0.961, which is lebih sampai 0.95. Bila you kira as, you masih lagi ambil Z tu 0.95 kan. Maksudnya itulah value paling maksimum. Bila dah bigger than 0.95D, masa you check untuk make sure yang Z tu 0.95 atau tak. Okay. Bila dia dah lebih besar, kita akan ambil Z tu tetap 0.95. Maksudnya betul lah you punya QK. Tak perlu redo using Z0.961, tak perlu. Okay, because you actually dah dapat the correct answer, which is QK you dah betul. Okay, okay. So itu saja for this chapter. Sebab ini chapter terakhir kita, chapter 2. Kita akan sambung chapter 4, sorry, chapter 3. Kita akan sambung chapter 4 today, and I akan post sekejap lagi.